The views and opinions expressed in this program are not necessarily the views of ECTV News, the City of East Chicago, nor this broadcast station or website. ECTV airs public meetings as a service to the community it serves. Speakers at public meetings, broadcast, or posted by ECTV News are solely responsible for their comments. ECTV News reserves the right to edit or remove any profanity or abusive language or behavior deemed inappropriate for our viewing audience. If you have any comments or suggestions about this program, contact ECTV News at 219-391-8206.
Welcome to today's regularly scheduled meeting for Monday, June 13th, 6 p.m. Will we all please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance? Pledge allegiance
to the flag
of the United States of America
and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Madam Clerk, roll call attendance.
Franciscan.
Present.
Ventura.
Present.
Vasquez.
Present.
Garcia.
Present.
Orange.
Present.
Maldonado. Medina.
Present.
Parks.
Present.
Santos.
Present. I did receive a phone call from Councilwoman Maldonado. She did state that she has some family issues that she was taking care of and she would not be able to be here tonight. She has to be excused. With that being said, the first thing on the agenda, we have the minutes for our council, our special meeting held, as well as our public hearing held Monday, May 23rd, 2011. The chair will entertain a motion.
So moved, Mr. President.
Second.
Motion made by Councilman Franciscan, seconded by Councilman Parks to adopt the minutes for the special meeting and the public hearing on Monday, May 23rd. Any discussion?
Yes.
Councilman Ventura?
I'm counted as absent on the special. I did come a little late, but I was here.
Madam Clerk? I believe the records state that you were here, but when we took roll call, you were absent, sir. So that's why it reflects that you were absent on the roll call.
Can I vote on it then? Or no?
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. Any more discussion? Madam Clerk, roll call to adopt.
Franciscan?
Yes.
Ventura?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Garcia?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes.
Medina?
Yes.
Parks?
Yes.
Santos?
Yes. Motion carries. The next set of minutes were the minutes for our meeting, our regularly scheduled meeting that night. Also having a public hearing that night on May 23rd. The chair entertained a motion to adopt those minutes for that night.
So moved, Mr. President.
Second.
Motion made by Councilman Vasquez, seconded by Councilman Franciscan. Any discussion? Madam Clerk, roll call to adopt.
Franciscan?
Yes.
Ventura?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Garcia?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes.
Medina?
Yes.
Parks?
Yes.
Santos?
Yes. Motion carries. Madam Clerk, do we have any communications from the mayor's office?
Yes, the oaths of office for East Chicago school board members.
Is there anybody here from the mayor's office? Can you give us your name and title, please?
Good afternoon. I'm Carla Morgan, city attorney for East Chicago, speaking on behalf of the mayor's office. In your packets are the oaths of office with the cover letter for the East Chicago school board members, which outlines that with the change in Indiana law, we thought it was prudent to err on the side of caution and present to you the amended oaths of the current school board members who were appointed under this mayor. And we ask that you approve them for the terms as stated in your packets. Yes, sir.
Oh. Are you done?
Well, I don't know if he wanted to interrupt.
He'll, He'll ask the chair for any question if you don't.
But that's basically what we ask, that you would approve them for the amended terms. And then secondly, also for the East Chicago Port Authority, for a moment I thought that those were not in your packets, but I believe they're in an envelope inside your packet. You all would confirm that you do have the oath of office for the East Chicago Port Authority members in there. If you don't, then we would withdraw and ask for you to consider that at your next meeting. But if they're in there, we'd ask for you to confirm the oaths also for the Port Authority. The Port Authority, by East Chicago City Ordinance, there is appointed by the mayor with approval and consent of the Common Council.
Okay, well, let's deal with the school board members first. Any discussion on that, Councilman Garcia?
I didn't get none of that in my packet. The only thing I got in my packet was Port Authority. I got nothing for school board.
Okay, the
did all the others have it?
Yeah, I have it in mine.
I don't have it.
You have school board?
Mm-hmm.
The only thing that was received in our packets wasn't the actual oath of office, it was a letter from the law department. If you would just look at your packets and see if you have this letter here. It was a letter. Wait, let's see. Well, you got the whole packet. See, I only got the letter.
I left it in the car.
Same letter twice about the board vacancies and then the Port Authority.
Okay, well, Councilman Garcia, if you want, you can have my copy, or if you would like the clerk to give you a copy, I mean.
Are we voting on them today?
That would be.
That right?
Yes, it's on the agenda, so yes, we will. So.
I'm trying to have a chance to review everything that everybody else had and have the same opportunity.
Is there any more discussion?
I agree with Councilman Garcia because I don't have it either.
Okay, Councilman Medina, if you would acknowledge the chair. Councilman Orange.
The school board we've already voted on, but I think that because in the past, in past administrations, these never went down to the clerk's office and they never actually were filed. And I think that's what we're doing is to rectify. But they were already voted on. They have been sitting on the school board. So I think it's just taking action for the fact of them having their office, the school board oath sent down to the clerk's office, which all, from my understanding now, that all boards are supposed to be done that way, and they never were in the past. Am I correct or no?
You're correct that there have been years, I'd say that about the last decade, since they've been filed in the clerk's office for practically every board of the city. And so
we're not actually revoting on these.
We're asking you to approve these people for the amended terms.
Oh. All right, boy.
Any more discussion, Councilman Medina? I know you wanted to say something.
No, sir.
Councilman Garcia?
Yes, like I said before, I just wanted to be afforded the same opportunity to see what everybody else got in front of them and review that paperwork also.
Okay. Again, it's the same people you voted, I believe, yes on before, the same three appointees, Mr. Frank Rivera, Mr. Clarence Lewis, and Mrs. Connie El-Amin. And we're not asking you to do anything different other than approve them for the terms that were amended with the passage of the East Chicago Elected School Board Bill. So again, you're voting for the same people you voted for before, but that their terms will end on the last day of December 2012 because the elected school board members will start their elected terms on January 1st, 2013.
Yeah,
Councilman Garcia?
I totally believe you, but I need to be afforded the same opportunity to look at it, research what was going on, and also the same opportunity just to look at it, research it, so I can vote on it.
Any more discussion? What I ask my colleagues to approve this, it's a simple, we've approved this already. It's basically stating that the law, legislative passed House Bill 1074, and they're gonna now, the city of East Chicago be, have the opportunity to elect a school board, and these members were approved and ratified by the city council, the majority of the city council. So all we're doing is rectifying some dates here. So with that being said, Madam Clerk, roll call to accept the school board members and their new appointments.
Franciski?
Yes.
Ventura?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Garcia?
No.
Orange?
Yes.
Medina?
Abstain.
Hartz?
Yes.
Santos?
Yes. Motion carries. We will be moving on now to the oath of offices for the Port Authority.
So, and if I may, the Port Authority, again, East Chicago City Ordinance mandates that the mayor appoints, but with the consent and approval of the council. There is one new appointee on the Port Authority that the mayor's asking you to approve today. That's Monica Guzman Gonzalez. And she would fill a term, an unexpired term that had been vacated by a resignation. Other than that, the rest of the board has served prior to this date, although none of their oaths were filed with the clerk. In fact, in some cases, oaths were not given. But again, we're trying to rectify all of these procedural things and ask that you today approve this board so they can function properly and we can get those oaths filed with the county circuit court clerk as they should be.
I have a question for Mr. Bauer.
Yes.
Mr. Bauer, do we have to go through these individually as a person, or can we adopt this, or can there be a motion on the floor to accept all the members on the Port Authority since they're all serving at the same time? Or do we have to go through them each individual?
Quite frankly, it's a question whether or not you even need to be doing this. I would say that the mayor's office is trying to be very cautious in resubmitting this and now dotting the I's and crossing the T's later. Because if the person's appointed and they file the oath, they don't come back and tender the oath to the council. So in this one, they do need to take action because you got Gonzalez that's you're
she's
asking.
New.
She's new. So for certain on Ms. Gonzalez, you need to approve her appointment to the board. I don't have the stuff that you gave to the council. You know, how they do the oath, I mean, they're gonna get it filed as required by, by statute. In a sense, this board doesn't approve the oaths. That's something that they need to do to be authorized to serve. But you do need to accept the appointment of Gonzalez.
Any more discussion? Councilman Ventura?
Gonzalez is not in here.
Guzman Gonzalez is not in the Port Authority?
This.
No.
It's not in here at all. Then I got another question.
You know, the chair would ask the attorney Carla Morgan, did you take this back since you did say that if the Port Authority, can you, at our next regularly scheduled meeting, get all the information that the council members are asking? Because it seems like we have a lot of missing information here on the other board appointments, so that you have them all. And maybe you can speak with Mr. Bauer and see, do we have to approve this all as one, or do we got to do individually? Maybe you can get with him, and so that we're not sitting here trying to go through this at the last hour, because some members have it, some members don't. So I suggest that we just hold off until our next regularly scheduled meeting, and you add that on the agenda.
That's fine, and we'll discuss it before the meeting with...
Before you walk away, are there any members that you want to ask a question so that she has that prepared for our next regularly scheduled meeting? Okay. Councilman Ventura, you still have the floor.
Yeah, the question is, how come it's for 6 months?
Because if you notice, they're all different. What we did is we went back to the statute, Indiana code that allows cities to create port authorities, and we went back to the East Chicago city ordinance that actually created the port authority, I believe, in 1999, and we calculated what the terms should be under the law, and whereas people were appointed before in the middle of a term, but they calculated the term wrong, and where certain people on the boards never did an oath, and then you have everything in between, we corrected the terms that they were supposed to be sitting for, because even if the oath is wrong, or even if you got the wrong dates, the actual terms under the law don't change. So we made sure that we were 100% correct on the dates that the people serve. So with some people, it's their term ran from 3.5 years ago in this December 31st, and then the term begins again January 1st of 2012. With others, they were only, maybe a year into a 4-year term. But in every case, we went back and corrected those certificates that you're looking at, and want to make sure that, the oaths are filed down in the county as they should be, so that people have certainty when you're appointed to a board, you're there and you're fulfilling a term that's set by law, and not that, people can arbitrarily shuffle you around, number one. Number two is we have to make sure that we're correct, because the Port Authority, along with our other boards, are very important to the city. They can, in particular, they can bind the city financially and that kind of thing. So it's very important that the administration of that board be done.
Okay, I got one more question. You got 5 appointments here.
Mm-hmm.
With Gonzalez, it'll be 6.
Well, it should be 5. I do apologize. I was out of town for a couple days last week.
How many board appointments are there?
There are 5 altogether for that board.
Okay.
So I'm not sure if there's a duplicate in there or what. I do apologize for that. And again, we'll gladly get it all corrected and make sure
there's not a duplicate. There's 5 different ones
five
here.
5 different names?
Well, Gonzalez is 6, which it should be odd.
Yeah, obviously it should be, but I don't know if there's a duplicate or what, but we'll certainly get it straightened out for you before the next meeting.
Any more questions, Councilman Garcia?
Who is Nina Guzman taking the place of? Ms. Guzman?
She shouldn't be in that packet.
No, but you say Gonzalez or Guzman?
Oh, Monica Guzman Gonzalez.
Yeah. Who is she taking the place of?
If I got my iPad, I hate to take your time up, but I could tell you it was a gentleman who stepped down from the board. And he resigned some time ago. But if you want that name, I can give it to you now, or I can give it to you after the meeting.
I don't see if there was probably included in this packet.
Okay. I apologize for not having hands-on with that packet to know exactly what you got and didn't get. But
is there a time limit that we have to get this passed?
If it's not done within 30 days of the date that those oaths were signed and notarized, then we'll have to re-execute the oaths. So that creates a time limit, but we can obviously correct that by having the board members come back in and redo the oaths. But again, there should be no problem with us having all our ducks in a row before the next meeting. And again, this is just, we want to make sure that everything is done properly. So I understand and appreciate you wanting to make sure that it's done properly.
Any more discussion, Councilwoman Vasquez?
Yes. Ms. Morgan, so when these terms are up December 31st, will then there be another Will the terms only run for 6 months, or they'll start at that time for 4 years?
Well, they're finishing an unexpired four-year term. So when that term is up, then a new four-year term will begin. We'll ask you again to approve the appointee. And their 4 years will start once they're approved and appointed. And it'll run from January 1st for 4 years until that December
31st. They will continue to be for four-year terms.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And that's how it should be under the city ordinance.
Yeah. Okay.
Any more discussion? Thank you, attorney.
Thank you, sir.
Carlo Morgan. Madam Clerk, any communications from, any more communications from the mayor's office? Any communications from department heads?
Yes, Wena Guzman, interim building commissioner, building department. Is she here?
Is there anybody here that's to represent the building department or the building commissioner?
Okay. Carla Morgan, City Attorney's Office. Again, we anticipated that someone from the building department would be here, but these that are on the list, and everyone does have this letter from Commissioner Guzman in their packet. I hope that you do. Are for emergency demolitions. Each one of these is deemed to be an emergency. We have buildings that pose an immediate health hazard in the community. And she is just, again, erring on the side of caution to keep the council aware of these emergency demolitions because they unfortunately are expensive. Where the city can, we are going after the property owners to recover. Well, in every case, the city is going after property owners to recover the amount of the demolition. But under the unsafe building law, the building commissioner is enabled, she's empowered and obligated to remove these immediate health hazards to the community. So I don't know if there's questions on specific ones that mm-hmm. I could try to address. Yes, sir.
Councilwoman Vasquez?
I have a question regarding communications from here about this issue.
Okay, we are in communications for department heads. Any questions from there?
No.
Councilman Ventura?
4907 Alexander.
Yes, sir.
I understand that areas in the 3rd District is a Superfund site.
Yes.
Did they follow the protocol, the procedure?
Yeah, the bid reflected that, and The specs in the bid say that the building is to be taken down only to grade mm-hmm. and that the foundation and anything below just ground level will not be removed. But the contractor is has agreed that they will fill in and bring everything up to level, compact the ground, and fill in with clean field dirt so that when you look at that lot, it'll just look like a grassy area, like an open field. Mm-hmm. And that's so that the lead in the ground won't be kicked up and disturbed and thus causing any additional contamination of, you know, people in the community, especially the children there. But compacting it will mean that there'll be a minimal amount of settling and collapse after the construction is done. So the contractor is aware that was part of the bid and it's part of the contract that they signed, that they will respect that it's part of the EPA Superfund area, and that they will do minimal disturbance of the ground and leave it in such a state that it'll be safe for the neighborhood.
Any more discussion? Councilwoman, or Councilman Garcia?
Yes, I just want to thank Ms. Guzman. She's been very good at communicating a lot of things to me. Any mm-hmm. questions I ever pose, she answers them all. I know she has a couple of locations here in my district, but she's been very helpful and very instrumental in getting a lot of these tore down. Like I know we had a lot of problems in the past of trying to get these done, and I know we're getting a lot of this done now. Thank you.
Yeah, and I would say she has been very proactive and very thorough in addressing these problems, and we hope to one day have more funds available, whether they come from federal or other sources, mm-hmm. to address more of these problems in our city, because, you know, we're And she's working very hard to improve the city in that way, so, okay.
Any more questions? I have one, Attorney Carla Mori. Do you need approval from this body? Because the way I read this, it's just communications from her department to the city council.
Right. You don't need approval. Actually, the Board of Works has approved these expenditures, and the Board of Safety has done the approvals where they needed to. It's just to keep you apprised of the fact that of the dollar amounts to date, you know, there's a fund in the budget that's attached to this. And so just to let you know how these monies are being spent. And again, it's just to err on the side of keeping you all informed. You know what the administration is doing, and you know, you can make us aware of unsafe things in your districts that we may not be aware of at this time, so.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Madam Clerk, any more communications from department heads?
Accounts payable warrants, 06011CC.
Second.
Motion made by Councilman Parks, seconded by Councilman Franciski to adopt the accounts payable warrant 06011CC. Any discussion? Madam Clerk, roll call to adopt.
Franciski?
Yes.
Ventura?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Garcia?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes.
Medina?
Yes.
Parks?
Yes.
Santos?
Yes. Motion carries.
Accounts payable warrant 06-1311-CC.
So moved, Mr. President.
Second.
Motion made by Councilman Franciski, seconded by Councilwoman Vasquez to adopt accounts payable warrant 06-1311-CC. Any discussion? Madam Clerk, roll call to adopt.
Franciski?
Yes.
Ventura?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Garcia?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes.
Medina?
Yes.
Parks?
Yes.
Santos?
Yes. Motion carries.
Payroll warrant 052611.
So moved, Mr. President.
Second.
Motion made by Councilman Franciski, seconded by Councilman Parks to adopt payroll warrant 052611. Any discussion? Madam Clerk, roll call to adopt.
Franciski?
Yes.
Ventura?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Garcia?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes.
Medina?
Yes.
Parks?
Yes.
Santos?
Yes. Motion carries.
Payroll warrant 060111.
So moved, Mr. President.
Second.
Motion made by Councilwoman Vasquez, seconded by Councilman Franciski to adopt the payroll warrant 060111. Any discussion? Madam Clerk, roll call to adopt.
Franciski?
Yes.
Ventura?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Garcia?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes.
Medina?
Yes.
Parks?
Yes.
Santos?
Yes. Motion carries.
Payroll warrant 061011.
So moved, Mr. President.
Second.
Motion made by Councilman Franciski, seconded by Councilwoman Vasquez to adopt payroll warrant 061011. Any discussion? Madam Clerk, roll call to adopt.
Franciski?
Yes.
Ventura?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Garcia?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes.
Medina?
Yes.
Parks?
Yes.
Santos?
Yes. Motion carries. Madam Clerk, do we have any ordinances on first reading?
No.
So, Councilwoman Vasquez?
I have a question. Going back under communications from the mayor's office, we all have a letter in our packet.
Councilwoman Vasquez, can you bring that up under new business or old business so we can move along? Madam Clerk, do we have any ordinances on first reading?
No.
Do we have any ordinances on second reading?
Yes. 11-0009, sponsored Councilman Richard Medina, an ordinance amending ordinance number 2752, entitled 15 of the East Chicago Municipal Code, the zoning ordinance, and repealing all other ordinance in conflict therewith by deleting section 156-125C, thereby eliminating boarding houses and lodging houses as a permitted use in the R2 family dwelling district, and by amending section 156-077 to include boarding houses and lodging houses as a special use.
So moved, Mr. President, on second reading.
Second.
Motion made by Councilwoman Vasquez, seconded by Councilman Medina. Any discussion? Madam Clerk, roll call to adopt ordinance 11-0009 on second reading.
Van Siski?
Yes.
Ventura?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Garcia?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes.
Medina?
Yes.
Parks?
Yes.
Santos?
Yes. Motion carries. Madam Clerk, any more ordinances on second reading?
Mm-hmm. 11-0010, sponsor Mayor Anthony Copeland, an ordinance amending the fire and wage resolution for fiscal year 2011.
So moved on second reading.
Second.
Motion made by Councilwoman Orange, seconded by Councilwoman Vasquez to adopt ordinance 11-0010 on second reading. Any discussion? Madam Clerk, roll call to adopt.
Van Siski?
Yes.
Ventura?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Garcia?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes.
Medina?
Yes.
Parks?
Yes.
Santos?
Yes. Motion carries. Madam Clerk, do we have any more ordinances on second reading?
No.
Any ordinances on third reading?
Yes. 11-0011, sponsor Councilman Rich Medina, an ordinance amending ordinance number 098-0026, entitled 15 of the East Chicago Municipal Code, by deleting section 155, 165, and 155-166, and establishing a uniform schedule of fees for the City Plan Commission, Board of Zoning Appeals, and Planning Department.
So move on third and final reading.
Second.
Motion made by Councilman Parks, seconded by Councilman Medina, to hear ordinance 11-0011 on third and final reading. Any discussion? Councilwoman Orange?
It was just brought to my attention by a couple of the residents about the fees. Because on here it's a residential application fee for $50. And then if you want to do a fence in your neighborhood, if you want to put up a fence, and that's another charge. And kind of wondering why, like, the building department or whoever else, they didn't kind of get together and put these fees together, so you're paying one fee instead of having to go to the building department and then going to the zoning department to pay a different fee. You got like two fees. Any reason for that?
This fee schedule, Councilman?
Yes.
This fee schedule was put together by our city planner, Mr. Dwayne Williams, who evidently is not in the audience today. And I think that he could best answer that question. If you wish to hold off on the third reading, we can do that, Councilwoman Orange.
I would like to. I mean, just to answer that question, these hard economic times, I know we got to make some cuts, make some money. But if you're putting up a fence and that's beautifying your neighborhood, and then you got to go to planning and pay another expense, I just think it should be combined if that's where you're going with that. As far as the fee scale, I understand what he had said the last time, but if we could just hold off, I mean, I'm sure there's a way either to combine it or 25 from this department, 25 from that, to come up with the $50 for the resident. We had the same situation where the landlord fee was waived, so a possibility we could look at that.
Councilman Parks?
I withdraw my motion and make a secondary motion to table ordinance 11-0011.
Second.
It's a secondary motion on the floor to table ordinance. Ordinance 11-0011. Motion was made by Councilman Parks, seconded by Councilwoman Orange. Any discussion? Councilwoman Orange?
Then we asked Dwayne to come up and also maybe need to talk to Wena Guzman to see what the fees are exactly for through the building department when they do put up a fence or anything else on their property. So we can get a schedule of the building fees and also the schedule fees for the planning. So people kind of know where they're going if they decide to beautify their.
Councilman Medina, if you can set up a meeting, since you are the sponsor of this and you sit on the Planning Commission with the those folks. Councilman Medina?
Yes, I will sit down with our city planner and make sure that we expedite that as soon as possible. Again, there's always a mix-up on where the residents are supposed to go, who they're supposed to see, and they're trying to streamline everything at this point, trying to make everything uniform, trying to make it a one-stop shop at the planning office, and we'll get some answers. I'll meet with Mr. Williams myself.
Thank you. Any more discussion? Madam Clerk, roll call to table. Ordinance 11-0011.
Franciski?
Yes.
Ventura?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Garcia?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes.
Dina?
Yes.
Fox?
Yes.
Santos?
Yes. Motion carries. Madam Clerk, do we have any ordinances on third reading?
No.
Moving into our resolutions, do we have any resolutions?
Yes, one. Resolution 11-0008, but we voted on that this morning, so.
Yes, that was going to be removed off the agenda since we dealt with that at our special meeting today. So is there any more resolutions, Madam Clerk?
No.
Mm-hmm. Okay, moving into old business. Councilwoman Vasquez?
Yes. I believe every member received a letter from the mayor's office from Carla Morgan, our city attorney, regarding vacancies on various boards. And Attorney Morgan is requesting that we fill these vacancies. I just wanted to know what boards have vacancies that this council needs to approve.
There are over 20 active boards with the city. There are also a few boards that are still referred to in the city code that are not active. And there are a number of positions on those boards that this council either has, as with the previous ones that were presented today, has the responsibility of approving the appointees of the mayor, but the letter concerns ones that this body directly appoints, and there are a number of them that the mayor's desire was for you to work with your council to identify those, and we'd obviously be glad to assist, but where the council has a responsibility to you all identify them, you all place people on those boards, but again, we'll be glad to work with you on what the proper terms are, because again, a lot of that has drifted in recent years. Any other assistance you might need. So
who's going to notify us what seats are available on what boards? That
well, again, this is actually a council function, mm-hmm. and the purpose of the letter is to alert you all that there's a council function that you may or may not have been aware of, because again, things have maybe been done differently, but we're trying to make sure that we comply with state law and the city code on all these appointments and anything else that we do. So again, we ask that you work with your council,
okay,
and the mayor's office and the attorney, city law office is, you know, obviously going to work and answer any questions and respond to any requests with regard to this. But So that's it.
Okay.
And you know, Attorney Morgan, in regards to these appointments being vacant, as you know, I was elected council president at the beginning of the year, same time that the mayor came in, and there was a lot of stuff that unfortunately, like we were trying to do today, that weren't in our packets, that, you know, board members. So in regards to that, I would ask that if you know and if you have knowledge that these appointments are vacant, that you do, you know, I have no problem setting a meeting up between our attorney and whoever represents the mayor's office, but the only way it can get rectified is if you know and we don't know, that we do know so that we can rectify it. So I ask that you sit down with our attorney and we rectify that problem, and this council has no problem moving forward and rectifying any of these matters. And just for an example, like all the ones we had today. So if you would do that, we could move forward, and then I guess we would take care of the problem.
We're glad to help in the spirit of cooperation.
Thank you. Is there any more discussion? Any more old business? Attorney Bauer, before you leave today, can you arrange that meeting with you and Attorney Morgan so that we can, the city council can move forward on that and get these issues taken care of?
Yes.
Thank you, sir. Are there any more old business? Any new business? Councilman Garcia?
Yes, Madam Clerk. I got some pictures here of a tree in front of 3942 Parish. This looks like it's starting to push up the curb and the sidewalk. Can you send that to the park department, also make a copy for the engineering department so they can be aware of that so we can get that tree removed? And also, if they could notify me what's the plan of action of removal or of trimming.
You still have the floor, Councilman Garcia.
Also, can you send a letter to our health department, also to the Indiana Environmental Management Center? I have a lot of people complaining about pollution in Marshtown, a lot of dust that's like real crystallized that's coming down, to see what they could do or any monitoring devices that maybe we could put up over there in Marshtown.
Any more new business? Councilwoman Vasquez, I know you had your hand up.
Yes. I received an email from School City today, and just to make our viewers aware that watch us on TV, I'm sure that I'm hoping all the students have received a notice from their schools letting them know that there is a program, Healthy Hunger Free Kids Act of 2010. And a lot of the schools here in East Chicago are offering free breakfasts and free lunches for the children. And there are quite a few schools that are participating in this program. So I just want to make the public aware that if there's someone in your neighborhood that's in need and they need to, you know, participate in this program, if you look up, go to their website, which if anybody's interested, I'll give it to them. And look at all the schools that are participating. The only requirement is that you be, free meals are available to all children 18 years of age and under, and to persons over 18 years who are enrolled in a state-approved educational program. Central High, Block Middle School, Franklin, and a list of schools here in East Chicago are participating. So I just wanted to mention that because I know a lot of us here in East Chicago do know some children that could participate in this program and get a free breakfast and a free lunch. Thank you.
Councilwoman Orange?
Just a couple of announcements. The FOP is going to have a safe summer kickoff. That's June the 18th. I thought somebody from the FOP would be here tonight. But in conjunction with the mayor's office and a number of other agencies, we'll conduct a safe summer kickoff, trying to keep our children safe for the summer. One thing they will have is Dunker Cop And Mr. Parks said he will be in that dunk tank, so.
Oh, I gotta go.
A lot of counsel. But the truth is that it could be a very volatile summer. And we need to try. I mean, we've already had a couple of shootings and everything. We need to show our kids how to be safe, not only just for to keep away from gang violence or whatever, but to see other things that they could do, like in volunteering for the summer. There are no summer jobs, but you can volunteer and give back. That goes good on your resume. And for college, all colleges are requiring some type of volunteerism now. So, I mean, that's something that the young kids may look into and try to do. But that's going to be at Block Stadium, and that's, I think, from 10 to 2, Judah, something like that, 10 to 2. And that's going to be this coming Saturday. Also, July the 16th, and I got this from Miss Catherine Hill. She gave me this. It's going to be an expungement informational forum. And for those that don't know, a lot of times when youngsters were under the age of 18, they have problems with the law or something, but they have done good then thereafter. And they have a record, and the Kimbrough Bar Association is doing this free of charge to see if something that you did in your past could be expunged, which would wipe your record clean. Not everybody fits that bill. I mean, you cannot have shot somebody and come and get expunged, but there are things that have happened to people in their lives that they are truly sorry for, that they could possibly get this rectified. You can go and see, and they will tell you whether you can have it expunged or not. And that's going to be at the Boys and Girls Club, July 16th, and it's from 12 to 5. And I do have a copy of any information, or you can contact Ms. Catherine Hill and find out how to go about that.
Any more new business? I passed out a flyer here. I sit on the East Chicago Urban Enterprise Association. I did pass out a flyer here with the organization of Fruits of Our Labor, and they're going to be putting together a garden in the New Edition neighborhood. And I know there's somebody here that's going to be speaking later on when we open it up to the public, to just inform you on how members here of the council can help out. And I encourage my colleagues here to help out. This is a nice thing that's gonna be presented in the community. It's gonna uplift that community, and it makes for a nice place to just go sit down and relax. And you know, and hopefully some of the kids would, you know, buy into this and just, you know, see what East Chicago has to offer opposed to going and hooking up with some of these gang activities and things of that nature. And we're trying to beautify that area so that the kids and the neighbors can come together and commingle and know who your neighbors are and know who lives next door to you. Because in the long run, that all helps out. That helps out in our city when we all know who we are, and we know when there's somebody that doesn't belong or somebody different to the neighborhood. So I know that tonight somebody's going to be speaking under the public expression, and they're going to be asking that the members help out. So I encourage my colleagues that please, if there's anything you can do to help this organization, it's good. And they're here to do good in the city of East Chicago. That being said, is there any more new business? All right, we will be moving into the public expression portion of our agenda. I ask those that are going to be addressing the council to please fill out one of these requests to address the city council, slips. And when you come up, you have 3 minutes. And please state your name and your address for the record. With that being said, our first speaker, Mr. Clemmy Jones.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Clemmy Jones. I live at 3830 Euclid. I only have two things. The first one I want to address is these buildings project that he's doing right here behind the city. If everyone knows, those roots only about 6 to 8 inches in the ground, and they spread out this way. Well, they dug it out. God forbid there's a storm, a lot of those trees are going to fall. My other thing is, you all have power that you don't even know you got. That license for that casino was awarded to the city of East Chicago. It wasn't awarded to the casinos. When they did the bids, Resort got the bid. And Ameristar bought it. They bought the casinos. They didn't buy the license. The city still owned the license. You all don't have to come to them with hat in hand. You all own the license. You can dictate to them. All the gambling all over Northwest Indiana illegally, the house gets 10% of the gross. You all was getting 3 3/4. That's less what the book is playing. Anybody know anything about gambling? The house, the only thing they provide is a place to gamble. Whoever's doing the gambling, whoever's running the game, furnish the cards, whatever game they're playing. They also furnish the people that does the gambling. The only thing the house does is provide a place for you to gamble. And they get 10% of the take. Now they want to give you less. What you can demand is, we want 10% of the gross. Because we have the license, you all don't. For some reason, they want you all to think this is their license. It's not. When the state awarded it, it says Hammond got one, East Chicago got one, Gary got two.
Sir, you have less than a minute.
When Trump sold that boat, he didn't sell a license. Barton owns, has the two licenses. Really, he only has one. The city's supposed to have the other one. He bought the casino. He didn't buy the license. Thank you all.
Thank you. Next speaker, we have Nora Ferrer.
Good evening, council members. Hope all is well. My name is Nora Ferrer. I reside in Valparaiso, Indiana. I am the president and founder to an anti-violent non-for-profit organization called A Sister's Cry for Justice, based here in East Chicago. Our mission is to support the families that have been impacted by gun violence and to heighten the awareness to the cold case files here in East Chicago. We'll be having, A Sister's Cry for Justice will be having its third annual National Night Out Against Crime event on August 3rd, 2011. This event will be located at the East Chicago Police Department's parking lot from 6 to 8 p.m. This event will end with a vigil walk in memory of those lives taken by gun violence. Sister Cry for Justice is asking the council members for your support for this event. We are trying to raise $1,000 in planning this somber evening. We are working diligently with other organizations, ICUC, the Buyback Program, and Crime Watch to reduce the gun violence in our community. We hope you all attend this evening and support us, and also for the families that have been impacted by gun violence. We thank you for your time and attention. God bless.
Thank you. Next speaker we have, Byron Duke Florence.
Mr. President, members of the council, Madam Clerk, my name is Byron Duke Florence. I reside at 504 East 150th Street, East Chicago. You know, it's a delight to see that the council and the mayor's office are working hand in hand, especially now that Ms. Morgan has just acknowledged about the appointments the council have. You actually have seven, so I'm gonna give you a head start on that. So, and I hope you make good decisions on those seven board appointments. My concern today is something that I think should be the concern of everybody in the city of East Chicago, that, you know, just not too long ago, this city was covered in snow. Now we're here for the summer. And our main concern now should be the concern of our most precious commodity, and that's our youth. I'm concerned, will we have a summer program? I've had the luxury of speaking with Councilman Parks, and he's kind of assured me that, you know, that the council and the city are diligently working to get this thing off the ground, and I hope it happens. I think what we need to do as citizens and council members, got to do a little bit thinking out of the box. Right now, I know the city's just from the past administration, financially, we in a catastrophic situation. It's no money. But we got to do some creative thinking. And I'm just throwing some things out there, and you can tweak them and do them any way you can as long as you get some positive results. I mean, you got the civil city, you got housing, you got the boats, and you got the schools. I think y'all need to kick in some kind of revenue to create some of these jobs. And I think a lot of emphasis need to be placed on these people getting jobs. It's almost impossible to do it right now, but for future thinking, I think we need to come up with a program that's some incentive to these kids. I mean, when they come in, let's make it clear, mandatory citizen of East Chicago, bringing me some proof, bringing that report card along with your attendance. And whatever grade you got, in order to get a job next year, you must show me some improvement in your grades. You must show me that you've improved your attendance and reward those college kids that are in school that are coming back here for the summer.
Less than a minute, sir.
Will it keep the crime rate down? Most definitely. Would it give them some incentive to get more money into the schools because the grades have improved, the attendance has improved? Most definitely. So I just think that's something that we need to sit down as citizens along with the council and all these other different government entities and come up with a structured program to make sure that our youth are taken care of.
Thank you, sir. Next speaker, Melvin Mobley.
Melvin Mobley, 3620 Parish. Now, I just have about three or four things. First of all, I just want to mention, how in the world can you charge people fees who want to work on their own property? People should be able to work on their property without paying fees to city officials or city as whole. I mean, it just doesn't make sense at all. Second, secret meetings, again, I thought we were beyond that. I noticed we had a secret meeting at 10 o'clock in the morning prior to the council meeting. And from what I heard the last council meeting, the council president approves. He said he has no problem with secret meetings. I seen it in the Hammond Times also. Now, unless they misprinted it, I'm not sure, but it did say the council president. This has to stop. And whether you people stop it, or it will be stopped. If we have to call the major news people in, we will have to address these issues in the city of East Chicago. I don't think some of you have a clue as to what's going on out there in the street. You sit up here, you're looking at one another, you're laughing and giggling about all this. I had three young men come to me last week on Parish Avenue. And when they stopped me and told me, we wouldn't be doing what we're doing if these people gave us jobs. But I understand you don't want to hear that because you're too busy taking care of you and your own. It's a shame to sit up here and have to address this issue. Now, someone brought up they're going to talk to the health department about pollution in Markstown. Come on, this is East Chicago, Indiana again, the most corrupt city in the world. Pollution in Marktown has been going on for years. When have we ever addressed that pollution in Marktown? Can anybody give me an answer? I didn't think you could. Because you want to address what you want to address and not the issues. The issues is jobs. And the same thing I tell these young men out there, well, look here. If they can't give you jobs and they steady filling their pockets up, then you need to address them. Anyhow you feel like addressing them.
Sir, you have less than a minute.
And now I have less than a minute. Here we go again. Every time I get cut off, but that's okay. Now, we spoke about something about the police officers. You people have problems in this city, and it's going to get worse. You're talking about police officers. Number one, this police department is the most corrupt police department in the world.
Thank you, sir.
Bottom line.
You have extended your 3 minutes. I have a time watch here, and you extended it. The next speaker, Mr. Carlisle Edwards.
Here I go, getting cut off again. You just said I had a minute.
Thank you, sir.
All right.
Next speaker, Mr. Carlisle Edwards.
Good evening. My name is Carlisle Edwards. I reside at 532.
Point of order. Would you escort this gentleman out? Thank you.
Okay, once again, my name is Carlisle Edwards.
Hold on, Mr. Edwards.
Okay.
This is the second time we had an interruption by this gentleman where he has used vulgar language. I, as a chair, will not tolerate that. I made that clear once before. I know the members at home that are watching the program cannot hear, but as he walks out, he makes vulgar and he's cussing. And we aren't going to tolerate it in this council meeting. And if I have to evict him from here, then I will. So I'm asking any of the other members that are going to be speaking, please, with all due respect, we're here to handle business. We listen to your concerns. You have 3 minutes. When your 3 minutes are up, they're up. There will be a next meeting you could attend. You'll have 3 more minutes. But please, with all due respect, there's no need for you to come up here and cuss at us. Mr. Edwards, I apologize. You have the floor. And you have 3 minutes.
I'm not even going to use all of it. My name is Carlisle Edwards. I reside at 532 Riga Place. First thing I want to address is we have a vantage point of looking over the parking lot behind the building department. The unfortunate thing is, since the gates are never closed, over the weekend and sometimes in the evening, there's a lot of kids that congregate there. And unfortunately, I would like to see something done to not only protect the city property, but also to protect the safety of the kids, because there's all those piles of bricks, all the heavy equipment back there, and everything else. I think there should be signs posted that say authorized personnel only and no trespassing. And I think the building department should start following a practice of whoever's the last to leave should close the gates that are there. I think they're functional and they should close them just so, because we've called the police on several occasions and kids seem to have the right timing in their heads because they're already out on 145th by the time the patrol car comes. So I think that's one issue that needs to be addressed. Also, I want to just voice my support for the Sisters Cry for Justice and also for the ICUC, which I'm a part of. We are also planning a lot of programs on community awareness and community education that I would like to see the city council support. Thank you.
Thank you. Isabel Blair.
Good evening, council. How's everyone? Isabel Blair, 4758 Drummond Street, East Chicago, Indiana. Okay, what I want to talk about is I want to ask the board to take a serious look at the fees they're talking about charging the citizens, the homeowners here in East Chicago. Because, beautifying your property, there shouldn't be a fee. I think that's not fair for the citizens here in East Chicago. And also, I heard that the landlords that rent property here, if they put a fence up, they only charge a $10 fee, you know. So you need to really look at it. How could you charge the homeowners here in East Chicago that's going to beautify East Chicago more so than they're running a business when they're landlords? because they are getting funds from renting out their property. So you need to look at them fees and make the right decisions on what we can do that will better serve the citizens here in East Chicago. Okay, and then I wanted to talk about the gas, some gas stations here in East Chicago. I've noticed I wanted to get the gas regulator's number because we need to have her attend one of these meetings too also, or even get the number so we can have it, because a lot of these gas stations are gas gouging, whatever they call it, gas gouging, because I go past and I've been writing down and they're changing their prices every other day. And I know they're not buying gas every other day, you know. So it's nothing, it's something wrong there when they're going up and down on their prices every other day. You know, it shouldn't be happening like that. I know I want to need to find out if they're buying, how they're buying their quantity of gas. I know they're buying it every day, weekly. You know, I understand the gas going up even the weekly, but every other day, is something wrong with that. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Last speaker of the night, we have Carolyn Plair.
Hello, Council. My name is Carolyn Plair. I live at 4023 McCook in East Chicago. And I'm the one introducing the Fruits of Our Labor Community Garden. The purpose of the Fruits of Our Labor Community Garden is to unite our city, educate our citizens, and to teach the young and old preventative skills and techniques that can lead to a healthy lifestyle, helping our youth stay out of mischief and just gaining a richer heritage by bonding with their neighbors. This is a newly formed grassroots organization. It's been supported by Mayor Copeland's office and the East Chicago Department of Redevelopment and also the East Chicago Urban Enterprise Association. There is also on your, on the packet that you received, there's a margin on the side that tells you who our committee is, and those are some pretty good people that I'm able to work with. Let's see. We are going to be having a groundbreaking ceremony June the 16th at 4019 McCook Avenue in East Chicago. It will be for our first garden. It's not just for the community of New Edition, it is for the community of East Chicago as a whole. So it should not, I don't want it to just be isolated for just people to say that this is just for New Edition and for beautification and for things like that. This is also something that's going to help the youth. We want to attach the youth to it so that they're able to learn some skills. It's also, we hope that it will become something that can produce jobs down the line. So it's not just something that's for right now. We're trying to make our minds expand on this, okay? And for my council person, I would love to see you there at the groundbreaking ceremony. And we need help. We need stuff. We need everything that's germane to gardening. So we need hoses, everything there's, it's on your list. So everything that you can give us, your time is the most important thing. We have sublots that come at a cost. So the cost is for the maintenance for, you know, for the property to keep it beautiful so that it is not an eyesore. It's not something that we want to become that, okay? So all questions and participation and anything that you have can be directed to me. My name is Carolyn Player, or either on the list. There's also for Denise Thomas Hunter. Her name is on there also. Thank you very much for your attention, and thank you in advance for your participation.
Thank you. Madam Clerk, do we have any more comment cards?
No.
With that being said, the chair will entertain a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Motion made by Councilman Garcia, seconded by Councilman Franciski. Madam Clerk, roll call to adjourn.
Franciski?
Yes.
Ventura?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Garcia?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes.
Medina?
Yes.
Parks?
Yes.
Santos?
Yes. The dollar, 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 the dollar
Thank you.